Welcome to my rotisserie workout. This isn't a workout to make pretty six-pack abs. This is a functional core workout to strengthen your core. Two goals. First, to strengthen the core to help support your lower back and minimize the chance of lower back pain or injury in everyday life. The second purpose is to strengthen the core as a preliminary for doing exercises like squats or deadlifts, because doing those exercises with a weak core is just asking for injury. Now, there's two aspects to this core workout, and they're equally important: strength and endurance. The strength, for obvious reasons. You need strength in your core for everyday life and powerlifting alike. The second, endurance, is not quite so obvious. Muscular endurance, the ability to hold a static position for a long time, has been shown to be extremely important in reducing lower back pain. So in this functional core workout, we're going to work on strength and endurance. So here's the workout. Now, if there's any of these exercises you can do for more than 45 seconds, then go ahead and add weight so that you can only do 45 seconds. And you're going to find out why I call this the rotisserie workout. It's because we're going to spin around like a chicken rotisserie. Let's get started. Okay, let's get this rotisserie workout started with everyone's least favorite exercise, the Superman. Lay down on your belly. Hands straight, legs straight, and up. Hold it. You're flying. Is that the right song? I don't know. Hold it. If you can do this more than 45 seconds, hold very light dumbbells in your hands. Okay, this is the first stage of our rotation. When you can't do this anymore, we're going to rotate and go into a side plank. We're going to hold this. Now, if this is too boring for you, listen to music and kind of bop to the beat a little bit. Okay, when we can't do this anymore, continue our rotation on our rotisserie and do weighted crunches. Excuse me. If you can do this more than 45 seconds, hold a weight plate behind your neck. Excuse me, I'm doing a video here. Okay, continue our rotisserie and do a left plank. Again, bop to the music. I strongly recommend you do music with this functional core workout. It makes it a lot more fun. Okay, continuing our rotation into a front plank. Again, you can bop to the music. Unfortunately, due to copyright issues, I cannot use music. Okay, that's it. That's the full rotation. Let's talk about how many reps and how many sets here. Well, we're going to do two complete revolutions, and we're going to do that every day or every other day. Because remember, our goal is endurance and strength, and so we're going to be doing this more often than a workout that is just cosmetic to make the abs bigger. In those kind of workouts, you would work them out hard and weighted and only maybe once or twice a week. Now let's talk about two more exercises that you can use to build up the strength and endurance of your spinal extensors to the point where you can safely do exercises like deadlifts and squats. Now, first, I know a lot of you will say, well, why don't you just do squats? That's the best way to work out your spinal extensors. I would disagree. There's a lot going on in a squat. And if you do these exercises, I'm going to recommend first to build up your strength of your spinal extensors. It gives you a lot more margin for error when you're learning to squat or deadlift so that you can learn to do those exercises without throwing your back out. So the two exercises that are awesome for building up the spinal extensor strength are, one, the Scooby Deadlift, SDL. There's a video here that'll show you how to do it. And the Bent Over Row for Lats. Both of these are great exercises to gently build up the strength of the spinal extensors as well as the endurance. So that's it for this week, my rotisserie core workout. Auf Wiedersehen.